First game, Liu Shi went to serve. Love all.
Yeah, Adam, you mentioned there, of course, that the matchups for those five matches that they played, the last five, all in 2019. The most recent one in the Asian Championship. Sun Ningxia won three straight games.
Now, in all fairness, that was more than 2 years ago. Mentality plays a big role in table tennis. I would pick Sun Ningxia to be the strong favorite here, but you never know.
One all.
Yeah, that was in the final of the Asian Championships. Hitting, like you said, a little bit earlier than you might have expected in the past.
Hi.
Lovely, lovely rally, so early on.
Just to be clear, more than a little bit, this is the round of 16, meaning there are 16 women left in this tournament, and two of the best in the world are facing off. I mean, in the past, semifinals or finals seem to be it. I mean, even a quarterfinal meeting between these two would be a bit rough and almost impossible.
2-1. Two, all.
Yeah, there's some of those fans we're talking about.
Shasha has some fan clubs of her own, though, so you will hear a little bit of back and forth in the crowd, some banter, so to speak.
Two, three.
Good receive here. Keeps this one low enough behind the net that even the forehand flick of Liu Shiwen doesn't have a lot of wiggle room. Now, neither of these players is especially tall, but the taller of the two, Sun Ningxia.
And for those of you who didn't see it earlier, these two.
And start getting prepared for Doha.
Four, three.
This is clever. So Sun Ningxia plays a touch shot, plays short as Liu Shiwen's backing up. And the second time, Liu Shiwen was ready for it. But this one just not quite getting the feet where she wanted. So a lot of touch play here from the world number one. First tournament is world, or first event, I should say, at world number one, Sun Ningxia.
Three, five.
And now Bill's little lead here, 2 points. It's the biggest lead so far.
Let three.
Five.
Three, six. Seven, three.
Yeah, she won't be happy with that. So, Liu Shiwen. Got some work to do here.
Eight, three.
That's a really good run of points at the moment for Sun Ningxia. There's some of her fan club. Finally, ace those consecutive points, Liu Shiwen.
It'll be interesting to see as table tennis review becomes a bigger part of the game, how serves change.
Good reactions initially from Sun Ningxia, but the power in the end from Liu Shiwen enough.
Yeah, that's going to be very tough to win points from back there. And against a lot of players in the world, Sun Ningxia will win these points. But the last two balls just a little bit inside, closer to the net, so Liu Shiwen able to counter on top. Fairly comfortably. But But just the opposite here. This time it's Sha-Sha, Sun Ying Sha on top of the bounces, controlling the timing.
Now game points for Sun Ying Sha. Wraps it up, Sun Ying Sha. Oh, wonderful down the line. Li Shiwen on the backhand.
Not easy to find an opening here. Sha-Sha moving around, one into the body. Real quick on that last one. It was like the Bruce Lee punch, just 1 inch, nice and short and quick. But enough pressure to stop your heart.
2-1.
Li Shiwen on her part, beating Jeon Ji-hee from Korea in straight games. And then Shan Xiao Nao of Germany, again, in straight games. These are the kind of rallies people want to see.
In all fairness, I read a lot of comments about the camera angles, and for me, this is the perfect camera angle for that rally. It was so interesting to see the pace and trajectory on every shot. You could really sense the speed and how they were looking to find the holes in each other's games. Again, in the women's game, typically, we see players playing, looking for the middle, fast backhand shots, but this was a lot of action from a step behind on both sides.
That's a lovely winner, isn't it? Dismissive almost from Sun Ying Sha. Took that on so quickly. 3-2 up, game two. Deep.
That might not have been the plan.
She also had a quick look up to the lights, I'm imagining.
Solar panel coach.
Well, the gift is returned. Sort of.
But the serve, not so much. Hey, yo. Just lining them up and knocking them down. I'll be here if you need me. Let me know.
You're here all week, aren't you?
Yeah, yeah.
Six, three.
3-point lead here.
Sha-Sha doing a good job of varying up her shots, how low these first three shots are. Sun Ying Sha turns up a bit of an arcing shot. Sun Ying Sha says, yeah, I can do that too. Let's keep it in the spin game right now, not go for the kill.
That was the third ball attack. She's seeming to have problems on that serve, receiving it. There's the coaches who don't want to get involved down there, watching from up above.
Cho Yuka, that's a funny way to put it. Cho Yuka trying to stay as far away from the table as possible. He wants nothing to do with this. No, when you work with both players sometimes.
Yeah.
3-8.
Can't tell your kids, you know, can't play favorites. Exactly.
Yeah.
My mom loves to share with me that there was one of her favorite writers who told each and every one of her children that they were all her favorites individually. But don't tell your sisters.
4.
But more variation in serve than any part of the game.
This is what the fans have come to see.
5.
Great table tennis between these two.
Yeah, Liu Shiwen really closes in on this ball, lunging, a bit of side spin, more of a chop block type receive, quick backhand, and on the move. I mean, she knew her body weight would carry her out of play here, so she had to make this shot count. Goes for the short side of the table. If that comes back, she's in trouble.
5-9.
I suppose the frustration for Liu Shiwen, she pulls off a great shot. She can't build up a run of points.
Yeah, it's rough. I mean, world number one, not an accident. Can be frustrating for anyone when you're playing shots that you're used to getting points for and they keep coming back.
5-10.
I suppose if you're saying it was if it was anyone else, she would be playing right now. At least she won. Those could be winners.
Yeah, I think there may be two other players in the game right now, Wang Manyu and Chun Meng, that might have a similar quality. But for the most part, yes, Liu Shiwen would have won a lot of points by now.
5 game points here to save, but she can't at the first opportunity. Sun Yingxia.
Mima Ito knocked out by Yuan Jianan yesterday.
1-love.
So the scoreline right now has been quite impressive and a bit of a landslide. I mean, Sun Yingxia's world number one for a good reason, but in all fairness, I mean, I would have expected this to be a much closer scoreline than it is, even at 2-0. 11-5, 11-5, that's domination.
Yeah, she's looked really good, hasn't she, Sun Yingxia? As we were saying earlier, Lucia weren't some of the shots she's playing, anyone else, pretty much.
They're winners.
Yeah. Just the quality of this player here. Oh, this is the best run of points she's had so far, 3 in a row.
Well, she does have her back against the ropes, metaphorically speaking here. It's a best of 5. She's down 0-2, so she must win this game.
Classic, isn't it, that one? Nicely put away by Sun Yingxia.
I like to agree with you. Classic, that's interesting. This to me is so impressive, how much wrist she generates here, so much racket speed in that short stroke. I mean, I just feel like years ago we might not have seen that quality shot.
Four, one.
What would Liu Shiwen need to do now against Sun Yingxia, because she's just looked so dominant in this?
Lee.
Well, I think just establishing herself firmly in the points, she's going to have to be clear when she plays long pushes and use Sun Yingxia's spin. Break here off the net. But for example,
sorry, use the spin you were saying.
If someone's farther from the table, when they take their aggressive shot, they have less angular advantage and you have more time to react and they have more ground to cover. Ooh, back edge of the table.
She needs all the fortune she can have right now.
Sorry. 2-5.
Wanted to make sure.
That should go to Liu Shiwen. Yep, absolutely.
It's a very polite play. And it was a very faint edge. You could understand why it would have been tough to hear.
Five, three.
So she wants to push Sun as far back as she can.
Yeah, anything she can do to catch Sun Yingxia just a little bit off balance, take control of the inside the table game. Xia Xia's game over the table is so strong, though. Liu Shiwen looking for answers here, and in the open rally, it's going to be tough unless she's got Xia Xia step behind and she's closer to the table. But here
look at that.
Yeah, I mean, you can see what happens. This was the torque I was talking about earlier, the waist and the twist. I think we got a timeout now from Liu Shiwen. Look how low she gets there, and the way she wraps around the ball to bend it out of reach. Okay, this is good for me. I mean, the opening backhand is very spinny. It's invested in the spin. It's not a kill shot, just quality. She's ready to rally here. She's not forcing it. We'll see if that'll be enough throughout, though. Xia Xia, I think, will adjust.
She's back there, Sun Yingxia.
It's that turn, the transition from the middle. Watch this, covers the backhand. And from there, look how wide her feet are. I mean, for a lot of people, you tear a hamstring trying to stand like that, and that's where she's bouncing off, twisting and changing between forehand and backhand.
7-5.
Second towel break.
Five,
Well, she was on the back foot a lot there, wasn't she?
Really had to chase. And another one where she says, I'm going for broke on this shot. On the move, that catches the edge of the table and climbs up, no problem. A beautiful shot under pressure.
Yeah, she's just got better and better in this third game.
Would have been an easy shot to miss. Would have been forgivable, at least in the mind of spectators. Understandable.
Well, we saw belatedly Darko Jogic start to really work his opponent around in the third game after two very easy first game defeats.
Six, eight.
Navigation issue here. The destination was set to backhand corner, and Sun Yingsha had a meeting point set up on the other side of the table. The timing, wow. I mean, Liu Shiwen nowhere to be found, not in danger of getting hit by that ball.
Beautifully placed, Lucia Wood.
Yeah, this is a very impressive quick reaction right on top of the bounce. This is the type of place she wants to have in terms of near the table. It was just a reactionary shot, but it was more than that because she didn't hit it just back into play. She played it to the one spot where it couldn't be touched. That's the difference.
Good aggression there from Sun Yingsha.
That forehand flick, such a powerful, useful tool to have in the short game. Backhand, it's easier to generate a little bit more spin, but she leaps up, gets in there with the elbow, and just snaps.
Just a point away, Sun Yingsha.
Bit of disbelief there for a moment. Liu Shiwen, but surprised that the ball didn't go where she had planned. It was played quite a bit out in front. Huh? Why'd you fail me?
Yeah, she didn't look too happy, did she?
Why'd you fail me? 1 point between them now. Second serve here. Big one. Does not want to give it back at 9-all.
But that's exactly what's going to happen. Oh. This is so similar to that last match. And she goes in front. Match points here for Sun Yingsha. Wonderfully done to wrap up this match. Sun Yingsha. Liu Shiwen finally turned up in game three. Much like Darko Jogic.